2024. I'm Angela Harmantas, and I'm joined by Jim McDonald, who's the CEO of Kootenay Silver. Jim, lovely to see you again.
Angela, it's great to be here.
Well, how are you finding PDAC so far?
Yeah, pretty good. I think it seems a little light this year, but we're getting a lot of buoyancy from the gold market and the silver market now, and that's popped the stocks, which is great to see. It makes everybody smile here. So
yeah, yeah. There's a lot of smiling faces if you're in the gold and the silver market these days. So, look, let's touch on Columba, which is your flagship project in Mexico. Obviously, it's a silver project. You've just had very, very good results coming from there. I know it's drilling on the D vein, wide open strike potential. Tell us a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so the Columba project's a relatively new discovery, and what we're finding is it's evolving into a vein district, in fact, that was unrecognized because it's not exposed to erosion, barely, just enough to see a piece of it. And we found it's much bigger than what's exposed, so it's entirely preserved from erosion, essentially, so whatever was originally deposited there is still there, and we've been drilling now for 3 years and getting just phenomenal results, especially on the D vein where we drilled it last this fall, and we're about to re-embark again in about 2-3 weeks' time to start drilling again there.
How many meters? What's the plan looking like?
We've drilled so far 30,000 meters in the project. I think it's 147 holes. And this next project will be about 5,000 meters, around 24 holes, thereabouts, stepping off that wide open D vein because we're getting intercepts there regularly, 10 meters of over half kilo silver regularly on that vein. And that the highlight hole being the best hole so far is the deepest hole, and it was 34 meters and a half kilo.
Wow. Okay. So, I mean, those are some good numbers that are coming out. What's kind of the plan for the rest of 2024 at Columba?
Yeah, we really focused on, for the companies, focused on Columba and drilling at Columba. We want to bring that up to a maiden resource here. We'd like to do it by the end of the year. It's going to be a little bit contingent on the markets, of course, and how much money you can raise. But we only need about another 20,000 meters to get to a maiden resource.
Okay.
And we'd like that, of course, the maiden resource to be as big as we can get it before we do that.
Well, you're getting there, and that's important.
Yeah.
Let me touch briefly on La Cigarra as well. You've just had news coming out of there with an updated mineral resource estimate, I think.
Take us through this. We did, and we've had La Cigarra for some time. It's in a great location in the Parral District of Mexico. This is a district that's produced nearly 1 billion ounces of silver, and we're on trend from an area that's produced 500 million ounces. We've got a large land package there. We've got a real good size resource base and a lot of exploration potential. And it's a pit-constrained resource that's been put in there. And when we acquired the project through a merger with another junior some years ago, we always felt the resource model was diluting the grade. And so in the last year or so, we redid all the geology, defined these geologic domains, and we found that indeed the silver was much more restricted. So we redid the resource to show that it was being diluted. And so the grade went from 85 grams, measured indicated grade from 85 or 86 grams up to 102.
Okay.
And we didn't really lose any, materially didn't lose any ounces. So it's a real big benefit. Better grade, fewer tons to move, and wide open for expansion. So this project at these silver prices is not really economic when you do some paper analysis. It's like close, but you get up close to $30, certainly over $30, it starts to look completely different. So we just wanted to get that project in ready for when we get into a silver bull market, and the market will be receptive to financing that.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, look, you've got some optionality there, and that's what we like to see is upside. Jim, it's lovely to chat with you again, and we'll speak again soon.
Great. Thank you, Angela.
Thank you. From the PDAC floor, I'm Angela Harmantas for Proactive.